Hi, I'm Amy Mednick, and I'm with Evolution Aircraft, and we build weight shift control trikes. This is actually one of our single seat trikes, which is an ultralight trike. What's special about it is that you don't need a license, there's no age limitation, and there's no training legally required. I don't suggest that, but that is the legal obligations. It has to meet certain weight specifications, fuel specifications. This one doesn't have a wing on it. We'll take a look at the one with a wing later on. But this one has a couple of special things. It's really made for in the morning flying or at sunset flying. You don't want to be flying in wind like this today. This is not something that will go well. You'll end up tipping over. It's really only for flying in light winds. The main thing is this is really nice because you can go off-road if you want to, or you can use it on a runway. A lot of people like to use this on their further farm fields or for flying in different terrains. But you're going to be flying a little bit slower. You're going to be flying for speeds up to about 45 to 47 miles an hour. You have a 5-gallon tank, which will last you for about almost 2 hours, believe it or not. But it's really nice. It's very light, takes off in a short distance, it lands in a short distance. It has a different type of motor on it. It has a Pliny Thor 250 on it. It has a different prop that's also free spinning. There's a clutch in it, so it's really nice for being easy and soft on the engine. This one doesn't have the ballistic chute in it right now, but a lot of times we'll have one right down here. And with this is the Thor 250. It's a Pliny. It's 36 horsepower. Something that's interesting about trikes too, to kind of backtrack for a second, you sit here and you have a control bar in front of you. And the way that you control it, it's a triangular frame. You hold on to the bottom. And if you want to go up, you push out. If you want to go down, you pull in. If you want to go to the right, you pull with your right hand and you roll right. If you go with your left hand, you want to pull left and you'll roll left. What's neat about this is when you're sitting in the aircraft on the ground, your right foot's your throttle, your left foot is your brake. It's a little bit different than most of the regular aircraft. Also, if you want to go to the left, you push with your right foot and you'll go to the left. If you want to go to the right, you push with your left foot, you're going to go to the right. And that's because it's like a tricycle, like when you were a little kid and you ride around on a tricycle, it's just like that for steering. What's cool too is on all of our models, we have some kind of instrumentation that'll show your engine information. It'll show you your fuel, your oil, your temperatures, all of that. And that's something that we have right here. We also usually have radios. Some people have transponders. You have different trim systems for our bigger models, where you have electric trim for pitch and then also in roll. Something that's really special about trikes is that they're delta wings. And so they have fabric wings. And so when you fly, the wing actually physically billows and shifts. Like how we have wind today, if you had any kind of turbulence, it'll billow in that area and it'll start to roll. So something that's neat about the trikes is how it feels in your hands. Like when you hold the bar, you can feel everything. You can feel the wind going through the wing. You can feel it in your fingertips. And it's very, very responsive. So when you go to bank and roll, it literally goes right with you, which is one of the most fun things about flying it. Also with this one, you have your kill switches over here. And all of our aircraft have like a kill system on them. So if something should go wrong, you can kill the engine right away. Most of them have ballistic chutes that are at least options. Most of ours have them on it. In Zephyr Hills, we actually have a flight school. And in that flight school, you can do all your training for different kinds of licenses. This one, again, you don't need to have a license, but we do really strongly suggest doing any kind of training when you're gonna go up in the air. You get a one-shot deal. So we do all kinds of training. We start off with taking you up in the front seat and get to familiar with the aircraft, getting familiar with the controls and how it flies. And then we'll take you through up to solo. Now, when you're ready to solo, you have to have your own aircraft when it comes to weight shift control. So that would be at the time where you would either have to have one of these to be able to fly for solo, or we have used aircraft and we have new aircraft. So that would be when you want to have your own aircraft to be able to solo in. And then you would continue flying solo to get some more experience. Then we do more intensive training with wind and emergency procedures and cross countries and get you ready for your licensing. And there's two different kinds of licensing that we do. We do the light sport licensing, which is where you need your driver's license. There's no medical required. Or your private pilot, where there's a medical required. You have to go through a little bit more training. One is a minimum of 20 hours for the light sport, minimum of 40 hours for the private pilot. Now, when somebody goes to solo, it could be anywhere from 8 hours all the way up to 20 plus hours. It just depends upon how you are and how comfortable you feel and when the instructor feels you're ready to go. One other thing is that our trikes are really awesome in regards to trailering. A lot of people really like to take these all over the United States. The Rev, the Revolt, the Revo, all three of them can be packed up very, very quickly. The Rev is the easiest, takes about 10 minutes from with its wing on and the way that it is into a trailer. The Revolt takes about 15, maybe 20 minutes to have it ready to go into the trailer. And the Revo, being a little bit bigger and a little more complicated, is about 20, 25 minutes maximum till it can go right in the trailer. The nice thing is everything is on quick pins. It's all quick release and it's easy breakdown. We have gas shocks to help you bring the wing up and down. And we have little dolly carts that you can put the trike onto, so it makes it really easy to put in and out of the trailer, which makes it really easy to take all over the United States or anywhere you want to travel. So you can do 5 gallons about 2 hours, and you're probably going to be flying around 42 miles an hour. Max load for this one is 200. The Revolt is a 2-seat trike, and so the max load is 250 per 200 in the front seat, 250 in the back seat, and it's an 18-gallon tank, and you can fly up to about 92 miles an hour, but the trim is set up from 55 to about 85 miles an hour. And so with that one, you can probably fly right around getting close to 3 hours. The Rev starts off at about 20,000, and that's ready to fly. And then depending upon what options you put on it, like radio, transponder, which most people don't for an ultralight, also with ballistic chute, different kinds of wings. So we have a single surface wing or a double surface wing. Single surface is awesome on something like this because it'll let you get off really quickly, and it's good in wind, not this kind of wind, but in wind it's good. It also has a double surface wing, but you're going to be taking a little bit longer to take off because it's heavier. It's not really designed for something quite as light, but it is an option. With the Revolt, you have the same options. You have a single surface or a double surface, but the double surface for that one will actually make you fly faster, and it helps with roll and speed. So it's really nice. That one's great for all terrains. You can take it in wind like today. You can take it up into the mountains and go flying. I just flew in Montana back in July, and it was amazing, absolutely amazing. Flying along the rivers and flying in the canyons, it was just incredible. So that's something that you can do with that and not as much with the Revolt, the Rev. Then we also have another model, which is the Revo, which is our flagship, and that's fully fuselaged. And that one has ballistic chute, synthetic vision, artificial horizon, and we fly those from Tampa all the way up to Oshkosh, Wisconsin, and back. So that's a fun thing to do. The Revolt actually starts off at 48,000, brand new, and it goes up from there depending upon what options you want. And the Revo starts off at about 85,000 and then goes up from there, depending upon what options you like. But all of them come ready to fly. So everything that you need comes with it. If you're interested in getting one of these, like the Rev or the Revolt or the Revo, you can check out our website. It's evolutiontrikes.com. That's evolutiontrikes.com. And it's all the information is right there. The pricing is all there. Your forms to download are there. You email us the information. You can call us with any questions or suggestions that you might need in regards to what you would like. And it takes from start to finish about 10 to 12 weeks. The cool thing is you can pick whatever colors you want. There's some standard colors, but these are powder coated. So this one has like a metallic in it. My trike's the purple one that's over there. That one is a custom paint job, but it doesn't cost that much to do those, especially since it's just powder coating. So still, it's only 10 to 12 weeks, and then it comes to us at our factory in Zephyr Hills, and then we put everything together with the wing and the carriage, and then we test fly it, fly off about the first 5 hours, and then the customer comes in and either does training or comes and picks it up and takes their plane home.